So today I'm going to start off with a little video.
Oh, I've seen that one.
Yeah, I know it's pretty popular. I've got a lot of people seen it. But this is pretty, like, important, so. It won't be too long. It's like 30 seconds or so.
Just think this one got one of the few that probably got rescued, so think of it positive.
Yeah.
Don't say
no,
that.
I would turn up the sound, but he's basically like screaming.
Oh, is he really?
Yeah.
Ooh, it's pretty bloody too.
The blood on the side of his arm is not from the nose, but from like a cut. But the blood from the nose is obviously on his face.
They got it. Good for you guys.
All right. Oh, that's not all of it actually. They had to pull out some and then cut it and then wrinkle it out.
Ooh.
But so what we have here is an olive ridley male sea turtle in Costa Rica, and a graduate research student and their professor slash marine biologist, Christine Figner, were out millions of miles from like the shore. I wouldn't just say millions, but hundreds of miles from the shore. And they were just kind of like out in the sea doing research, and they find a sea turtle, and they obviously can't bring it to shore because it'd be too far for them to get help. So she had to take it on her own to pull it out. And what happened was the sea turtle ate plastic. And instead of going down their throat passageway, it went up towards his nose, and the plastic was coming in from his throat out towards his nose. And they had to take it on their own, hoping that it wouldn't, like, was connected to the brain or anything. And Christine Figner, the marine biologist on this boat, just kind of captured the moment of, like, banning plastic in the bottle in this quote. We are grown-ups and we can drink in a glass without a straw. But straws aren't really necessary, which I think is really important to kind of see. And so, I put this up here because, as just a student, I don't really have a degree in talking about science, and I'm not a marine biologist, but I'm just really passionate about this movement, and that's why I hope that you guys listen to, because as a student, you have more power than you know. So, what am I going to be discussing today? I'm going to be discussing the effects of plastic in our oceans and our marine life, our global waste impact, your position in this change, and how to help. Okay. So according to National Geographic, there are about 5.25 trillion pieces and counting of plastic debris in our oceans. And you're probably thinking, okay, when I go to the oceans, I don't see like thousands of pieces floating on the beach. And that's because about 4 billion, also according to National Geographic, are in the deep sea. And this is really important because we don't get to see the effects of plastic debris because it's not floating on the top of our ocean as much. It's all underneath the ocean, so all of the effects are happening under the ocean. And so some ecosystems that are being affected like this are our beaches and our reefs. So in our beaches, there are natural homes of sea turtles for laying their eggs about once a year. And for birds, most importantly, they use beaches as homes for mating, birthing, and everyday living. National Geographic has spoken up about this and how that they have estimated that 90% of seabirds to this year consume plastic as of today. And as for our oceans, I'm just going to be focusing on the reefs, because I know that's really important. We had a previous classmate talk about how important reefs are to our oceans. Plastic pollution is similar to an infection. So when plastic is in contact with reefs, it cuts plastic, allows bacteria to grow, and it spreads, and eventually kills coral reefs. According to a 4-year study by NPR, when coral reefs become in contact with any plastic, their likelihood of disease goes from 4% to 89%. And since we already know the impact of coral reefs in our oceans, like stabilizing our oceans and our homes, preventing millions of homes from being flooded, a global food shortage, and the extinction of thousands of species, we aren't doing much about it. And that's just our ecosystems. So we are also harming our marine life. I know a lot of you guys really like animals, so I thought I'd talk about this. These are the top two ways we're killing off our marine life today. Entanglement is when a marine animal is entangled in plastic, also known as ghost fishing, and it's when all types of plastic become floating nets in the ocean. These pictures showcase a seal, a bird, and a sea turtle, but we also have sharks and all types of animals that are choked through plastic. Right here, I don't know if you guys have seen him before, but he's really popular in the media a few years ago. His name is Peanut the Turtle, and marine biologists have found him and taken him in, and there were a bunch of news reports done about him because they were joking about how he had an hourglass shape. But Peanut the Turtle actually was born, and he got stuck in like a 6-pack can packaging, which I know you guys have all seen before because you see those in the stores all the time. And it led to a deformation in his body, obviously, and that led to organ failure, similar to like a corset when people used to wear corsets back in the day. So he died from that. And then I'm also going to be talking about ingestion. Ingestion is pretty self-explanatory. It's when an animal consumes plastic. It's like the turtle video that we just watched, but luckily he, like, it came out of his nose, which sounds awful that, like, he's lucky because it came out of his nose and he didn't eat it. But that's because a lot more animals are showing up consuming plastic and dying from it. This is a sperm whale. And I don't know if you guys have ever seen whales in real life. I haven't. But they aren't supposed to be this flat. They're supposed to be a lot more round because they eat so much. Well, fishermen were seeing that a whale was floating near the shore and they didn't know what was wrong. So they pulled him in and it turns out he had died. And he was just floating dead near the shore. So marine biologists came in and they saw how flat he looked and how starved he looked. So they cut him open and they found 30 plastic bags in his stomach. And they came to realize that he either died of starvation or an infection in the abdomen due to this plastic. And 30 bags, whether or not you think that's a big number or not, when you chew on plastic and it's in your stomach, it stretches out the plastic. So it fills your stomach and you don't feel it, and so that's why they were starving to death. And this happened in 2017. And I only put one example because we have so many more examples of things happening like this. We have dolphins showing up this way, even larger whales, fishes, whales, sea turtles, and birds. So with all of these harmful and destructive effects, the U.S. is not doing anything to change. We don't have that many impactful environment laws with our oceans, and that's because government officials claim that we don't have a responsibility to clean up our oceans or enact a change. And that's because, as you can tell, we're not even the top three global waste users. This chart actually shows that the U.S. is 12th in the world for polluting the ocean the most, and China, when compared to China, which is 8.8 metric tons, 0.3 metric tons doesn't sound a lot, which is true. I mean, we're not wasting plastic. But the reason why people are still talking about this is because we're the third largest plastic producer in the world. So we're the cause of the problem. We are producing plastic for other countries to waste, and we actually export about 6.4 billion total in plastic yearly, which is a lot of plastic to export. So we're creating plastic for other countries to waste and allowing them to waste. So this is how we play into the system of plastic waste. And then on top of that, there's still people out there who don't believe that we should clean up the ocean. It costs us $120 billion per year just to make plastic, to produce it. And it would actually cost this company, Pacific Ocean Cleanup, it only costs them $122 billion a year to clean up the ocean. And in 5 years, they would have already cleaned up around 50%. So what can you do? As a college student, you have the power to make a change. If you just take a look at how much plastic you use weekly and how much plastic you don't actually need, and you may be thinking, yeah, I don't litter or I don't waste plastic, but if you're working towards a change to make it better, you're kind of just a bystander letting it happen. So we're affecting animals such as these, our sea turtles, our manta rays, our seals, birds, dolphins, fish, any type of animal you see in the ocean, we're affecting them. And if you don't care about your animals and oceans, we're also affecting these people. We're allowing little bits of plastic to be produced, exported to them, and for them to waste because they have nowhere else to put it. And so people like this and children like this are living their day-to-day life and filth because of us. So this is how you can help. It can be as simple as writing letters to companies or businesses to provide more eco-friendly material. So you could write to Chick-fil-A, which I'm not bashing on Chick-fil-A because I love Chick-fil-A, but they were actually one of the most plastic users on campus that we have. Because if you take a look at how much plastic, they have a lot of variety of foods. They plastic package their fruit, their cup lids, their straws, their forks and spoons, all of that they do. So you could write a letter to them. We also have petitions that you could sign for. One of the more important things is donating money, but I know that as college students, we don't have money to donate. So I'm a firm believer in volunteering, and I know a lot of us go to the beach. So if you go to the beach in North Carolina, you can always volunteer at the NC Coastal Federation, or if you go to any beach within the U.S., we have the Ocean Conservancy and the Surf Rider Foundation, and they clean up on the beaches, and they also take out people towards the oceans to clean up as well. But besides that, I think that informing our state politicians is the most important because they're actually the ones who can enact a lawful change. Our state senators, Richard Burr and Tom Tillis, I put their information up here, their websites. And guys, you can Facebook them, you can tweet them, and you can Instagram hashtag them and at them on any social media. But I would go with calling them instead because I feel like that's a lot more impactful is when they hear you. the number for the U.S. Capitol switchboard, which it'll take you to their switchboard, and then a desk lady will just ask you for who you want to talk to, and you just tell them that. So in conclusion, we've talked about the harms of plastic on our oceans, marine life, and animals, and now you. So now it's really just up to you guys to change, because laws can be enacted, but it's also about the culture of things. And if we don't change the culture of using plastic, because we don't really need plastic, we just kind of have it there to be used. So I'm hoping that you guys will make this change, and you guys have learned something today. And if anything, you can't litter plastic if you don't have plastic.
Okay.
Thank you.